What a sight!
Treasure chest.
Wandering around this deserted island, making me homesick.
Me too.
Thank you.
feels like we've been walking non-stop. Adol, can we take a break?
Given this island's obvious lack of light sources, I assume nights here would be pitch dark. And yet, the moons and stars are far brighter than I thought them to be.
We sailors rely on the moons and stars to help us navigate at sea. Some things can only really be seen at night, long after the sun goes down.
What made you want to become a fisherman, Sahad?
Huh? Why do you want to know? Guess you could say I didn't have it. I grew up on an island called Crete. Pretty much all we got there is the sea. Doesn't matter how old you are, if you want to eat, you gotta fish it up yourself. So, where I'm from, if you want to live, you gotta fish. Simple as that.
I can't even imagine what that must have been like. Wasn't it difficult for you to grow up in a harsh environment like that?
Harsh? I suppose. I've had my fair share of hardships over the years. And the sea, she could be gentle like a mother, but she could also be terribly violent.
Yeah.
I can hear it in your voice. The sea's made a lasting impression on you. She's made an impression on me, too. That's why I respect her.
What?
The sea is both bountiful and mighty. She's provided me with delicious meals and shaped me into the man sitting before you.
Shaped you?
You can't face the sea and all her grand majesty unless you first accept how small you are. The sea's no place for bluster or bravado. She don't stand for that nonsense. One careless misstep is all it takes to lose everything. Humans are small, fragile creatures, especially out there. When I realized that, I thought, I need to accept how small I am and be true to myself. And once I did that, I felt like I could face the world for the first time. That's why I don't like being dishonest. I've been true to myself for a long time, and I'm not stopping anytime soon. Damn right! I'm Sahad Nautilus of Crete!
Being true to oneself.
All right, I'm feeling much lighter now. Time to hit the hay. Let's get some shut-eye, you two.
Hold on a second.
Huh?
You will sleep near the entrance, Sahad. Mr. Kristen will sleep in the center, and I will be in the far corner. Wait, that would place me downwind. Perhaps I should sleep near the entrance.
luck on the search!
That fruit looks delicious. There.
there.
Injury at once.
Please be still. You seem to have sprained your ankle.
Hey. I, you ask? You are in the presence of Sir Carlin, honorable noble of the Roman Empire.
My name is Kirgar. I'm a doctor, actually. Who are you folks?
I'll take you guys back to Castaway Village.
Something there. treasure chest.
Ivy up ahead. I think you can use those gloves to climb it, Mr. Kristen.
Come on!
Wow! These are some great gloves. I bet we can reach more places now.
Yeah. Come on.
Oh, something's there.
Boy, am I glad to see you.
What happened?
Yeah, well, I need you to remain calm. Looks like beasts have surrounded Castaway Village.
Beasts?
So what Paro said was true. The beasts around here have been getting more ferocious lately. Why don't we go talk to the captain? He'll fill you in on the details.
Together.
Leave it to me! Thank you.
Let's get off this island alive!
Here, here!
Yeah, my family's still waiting for me.
Bring it on!
Coming through!